This meeting is being recorded.
Okay, then we'll just continue the class. Let her join later. Okay. Yes. My voice is audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, screen is visible. Screen is visible, right?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, then we'll continuing the class. Good morning, guys. Today we will deal with the floral concretes or the floral absolutes, essential oil, then how they are extracted. Okay, first we will see some of the history part. First, this essential oil or the aroma was date back to 5000 years back. The evidence was first seen in the ancient civilization like Egypt, Greek, Roman and Chinese. Why they have used these aromatic compounds? In order to preserve the food or in order to preserve the dead bodies, mummification. For that they use the essential oils. Then further they have the knowledge of aromatherapy, how to use these essential oils in order to cure the emotional or physical symptoms in the human body. Then with respect to how what are the chemical constants or the chemical compounds present in the essential oils, like mainly the alcohol based compounds, the linalool, citronol, geraniol. Where you can find the geraniol? In the floral crops or any aromatic crops or the medicinal crops. Can you name some? Where you will find the citronellol? Geraniol?
In rose, rosa.
Okay. Like that, you need to remember the chemical compounds which are all present in the rose, jasmine. Then the aromatic crops also very important. Who is dealing with the aromatic crops? Medicinal and aromatic?
Don't know, sir.
They are not teaching you aromatic crops, medicinal crops, plantation crops?
No, sir.
Okay. Then you can ask Nayak sir, na?
Yes, sir.
This part of this type of questions will be definitely appear in your exams with respect to aromatic and medicinal crops. Okay. So you kindly remember which are the chemical constants present in the that particular crop. For example, in rose, the geraniol is the chemical or the chief component present in the essential oil. Like that, aldehydes. In the aldehydes, citral, citronellol. This will comes in lemongrass. Have you heard of lemongrass?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You need to remember all those points. You have to learn the medicinal and aromatic crops also. Okay. Then further, the esters. In the esters, in the jasmine oil only we will find linalyl acetate and geraniol acetate. This is long oil. This is also one of the aromatic crop. Have you heard of this? These are all very important objective type questions. They will directly ask which are the chemical constraints or the chief components present in the this crop. They will give like lemongrass, patchouli, pomarosa. You need to remember all those things. Okay. Then further, ketones. In the ketone, we'll find jasmine, camphor. Which is the camphor plant? Have you heard of camphor plant? Basilium. Basil.
Yes.
Tulsi. What is the scientific name of camphor plant? Which is a species? This is also pakka question in your exam. You need to remember all those things. Okay. Then what do you mean by essential oil? Essential oil means these are all the volatile compounds, means quickly evaporating compounds. These are the aromatic fluids extracted from the plant through the steam distillation or any other distillation method. These are all essential oils. Then further, these oils are found in the tiny sacs or the globules within the plant. They are highly aromatic, and although referred as the oils, these are all the not true fats. These are all the not the fats. Then these essential oils can be extracted from the leaves, stem, root, bark, flower, resin, wide range of botanical plant materials. Can you give some example for the leaves where we all extract the essential oil? In the patchouli, we will extract through leaves, stem, roots. Vetiver, have you heard? Bark?
Yes, sir, vetiver.
Bark? Flower? Have you heard of Kevada, Pandanus?
Yes, sir.
These are all like general questions. From which part of the Kevada the essential oil or the aromatic compounds are extracted? They will give multiple objectives. Like root, bark, flower. Then you have to go for flower only. In the flower also, they will give male flower, female flower, hermaphrodite flowers, like that. Exclusively from the male flowers, this oil has been extracted in the Kevada. Okay, kindly remember this one. This is also a very important question. Then we will see some of the chemical constituents or the group of chemicals present in the flowers. Like terpenes, alcohols, esters, ethers, hydrocarbons, aldehydes. These are all the group of aromatic compounds present in the flower crops. Mainly after the extraction, we'll group into two types of products after the processing. These fragrant compounds we call concretes or absolutes, mainly extracted from the solvent extraction method. Are the supercritical fluid extraction method or enfleurage. What do you mean by SFE? What it stands for? Abbreviate SFE. Now only I told. These are all very important concepts with respect to your JRF or SRF. Yes?
Supercritical fluid extraction.
That's
fluid
it.
Fluid extraction.
Yes, great. Then essential oils. These are the volatile oils produced from the hydro distillation method or the water distillation or water hydro distillation or the steam distillation. We have n number of distillation techniques for the extraction of essential oils. You kindly remember, in the floriculture crop or in any aromatic compounds, we will see one is essential oil, another one is concrete, another one is absolute. These are the three terminologies you need to remember. Pakka, there will be the 2 to 3 questions based on this concept. Essential oils are mainly extracted from the lemongrass oil, lime oil, then eucalyptus, coriander, patchouli, citron. What is the speciality of patchouli oil?
From leaf or essential oil is extracted.
Okay, from the leaf it is extracted. This is a base note oil, means for any extraction of any further highly valued essential oils, this is used as a base note, means it is a fixative. like from the patchouli oil only we will extract the sandalwood oil. This is also very frequently asked question. What is the base note oil? Which among the following is a base note oil or a fixative oil? Then you have to go for patchouli. Means using the patchouli oil only we'll fix the sandalwood oil. Means we'll going to extract the sandalwood oil is highly valued and highly evaporating. That's why we use some fixative like patchouli oil to extract the oils. Generally we'll for the extraction we'll follow the three simple steps. One is we have to choose the right type of flour. We have to harvest at right time. Then we have to mix with the some solvents in order to extract the compounds, aromatic compounds. After that we'll get the concretes or the waxing masses. Then we'll go for the refining of the concrete to get the absolute or the viscous fluid or the essential oils. Then we'll deal with in detail regarding this. What are the main techniques in extracting the concretes or absolutes? This concrete and the absolute will come in one set of group. If you go for the solvent extraction technique or the supercritical fluid extraction technique or the enfleurage or the maceration technique, we'll hear the concretes or the absolute words. Okay. Then we'll see in detail in the floral concretes through solvent extraction method. In the solvent extraction method only we have three type of extraction techniques. More than five techniques we have, but mainly with respect to your competitive exams I am saying you. Okay. Mainly the solvent extraction is commercially followed in India. Here solvent extraction method, what do you mean by that? Here we will use some operators like Solhet operators. You will find in your labs glassware, the glass containing curved glasses will be observed. Your lecture may be told this is used for the concrete extraction and the essential oil extraction, and some practical classes you have been done also. This you need for solvent extraction, you need some operators, then you need some solvent. Solvent may be hexane or petroleum ether or any organic solvents. The extraction by percolation or the maceration at the room temperature by the continuous hot extraction in a operators at a constant temperature. Then the removal of solvent may be done through distillation under the reduced pressure. Okay, after the distillation through or the extraction through solvent extraction, this is mainly done in jasmine in order to obtain the semi-solid product. This concrete is a semi-solid product. In jasmine it is in yellowish to orange color. In the exams they will ask the semi-solid product extracted from the solvent extraction method is termed as, what do we call the semi-solid product extracted from the solvent extraction method?
Concrete.
Yes, concrete. They will ask the question in multiple ways and in haphazard objectives. For all those things you need to learn the concept. Under which concept the absolute will come, the concrete will come, under which concept the essential oils will come, and the floral waters will come. Like that you need to differentiate, then only you can answer easily. This floral concrete consists of the fragrant constituents with the lipid soluble impurities like fats, floral fats, waxes, albinous matter, then the pigments. This concrete is not the pure one, it contains the impurities like all these components. Further we'll distill the concrete to get the absolute. You got the concept? This is like impure floral. This is the impure floral product. It contains all these impurities. So in order to obtain the pure compound, we'll go for the further refining of this product. Further, they will get the absolute. You need to remember this one. Then before going for the solvent extraction, this is the solvent extraction. Now we need to select a good solvent. How you are going to select a good solvent? This solvent should be selective in order to extract the particular essential oil from the crop which you have targeted. Then it should be stable. It should be chemically stable. It should not react with the any other essential chemical constituents in the essential oil, and the boiling temperature should be low as possible so that we can reduce the energy on heating the mixture of this essential oil and the plant produce. Then it should be volatile in nature. It should not leave no residue after the evaporation so that we can obtain a fine concrete or the absolute. Then it should be safe to handle. These are the properties of a solvent. Then this is the solid apparatus. This is a heater, electric heater. This is the glass apparatus, flask. In this we will going to fill the organic solvent like hexane, petroleum, ether or any other organic solvent. Mainly this hexane and petroleum ether is commercially exploited. Then in this organic solvent, what will be there? Initially, if we get the, I will give the example of jasmine. We'll harvest the jasmine in the morning hours. We'll dry the flowers. Drying means not complete removal of moisture. Only we'll spread the flowers in the cool area so that the guttation or the moisture on the leaves or the petals may evaporate. Further, we'll mix the solvent in 1:1 ratio. 1:1 ratio or 1:2 ratio. So 1 kg of jasmine, how many liters of solvent is added? Have you an idea? You have any idea on this?
No.
Okay. For 1 kg of jasmine, we are going to add 2 liters or 2 kg of solvent. 1:2 ratio of the flowers and the solvent is added. After that, we'll leave for 2 to 3 hours or 4 to 6 hours based on the type of flowers we are using. After that, the solvent is completely extract the floral components in the flowers. We'll remove all the flowers and we'll left out with the organic solvent dissolved in the floral aromatic compounds in the jasmine oil. So for this jasmine oil and this organic solvent is heated from the bottom, so it will evaporate. Okay, this evaporative flask will contain extraction tube also. This extracting tubes further connected with the condenser. The aromatic compounds present in the solvent, initially we go for the heating. These solvents like hexane and petroleum ether have the low boiling point. They started evaporating and comes here due to its condensing ability. The cool chamber, it will condenses. It will form liquid. Further, it will be separated in a separate. We will keep a separate flask for this. So, like this, we will extract the solvent. After extracting the solvent, we will only left with the some semi-solid product that we call concrete. After evaporating all the solvent, it will contains the aromatic compounds, waxes, pigments, all these things. This is how the concrete is extracted from the jasmine through solvent extraction method. What do you mean by absolute then? These essential oils and the absolutes comes from the volatile fluid extraction technique only. This delicate flower such as rose, jasmine, orange blossom, or sometimes what will happen, after extracting through solvent extraction method, it will have the more impurities. In order to refine these impurities from the concrete, we will go for the further distillation in order to get the absolute. Okay, this absolute, this is different from the essential oil. It's also different from essential oil. Essential oil mainly extracted through water distillation technique. This is mainly extracted through solvent extraction method. Okay, you need to remember that one. This is a it contains highly density of colorant, waxes and other chemical constituents which are aroma. Highly concentrated aroma will be present in absolutes. Okay, these absolutes are mainly used in the natural aromatherapy or the therapeutic purpose. How absolutes are extracted? Through solvent extraction method. After extracting the concrete, we'll extract the concrete na from the technique. For that, we'll going to add ethyl alcohol. You need to remember this one. Ethyl alcohol. We'll add the ethyl alcohol. Then we'll thoroughly mix it and we'll kept in a cool chamber, minus 10 degrees Celsius. We'll keep in a refrigerated condition. So this ethyl alcohol will going to evaporate all the left out solvent like hexane and petroleum ether and the chemical impurities. Further, we will only left out with the absolute. This is a simple technique. We will mix the petroleum ether for the concrete. We'll keep in the refrigerated condition, minus 10 degrees Celsius. Then we will get the absolute. All the impurities will be evaporated under the cool temperature. That's it. That is the technique of extraction of absolute. Then we'll see some of the drawbacks in the solvent extraction method. One is the lack of selectivity. Which are the compounds we need to extract from the jasmine is linoleic acid or the jasmine. But in spite of all the chemical aroma compounds, we'll also extract some, this solvent also extract waxes and other impurities. This is a drawback. Then some of the solvents are toxic in nature. These are the main drawbacks. Then supercritical extraction method. Here the carbon dioxide or the nitrogen is subjected to high pressure. This gaseous form of carbon dioxide or nitrogen is turns into liquid. This liquid carbon dioxide can be used as a, this liquid carbon dioxide is very inert in nature and safe to use. So we will use as a liquid solvent in order to extract the aromatic molecules. So here no solvent residue remains after the extraction, since at the normal temperature and the normal pressure, this CO2 simply converts into gaseous form. Here in the supercritical fluid extraction technique, we will get the highly fragrant compounds devoid of unwanted material. This is the major advantage compared to solvent extraction method. These are the drawbacks. In order to overcome these drawbacks, this technique has been developed. Mainly here, the heat liable or heat sensitive are more volatile compounds of fragrant compounds are extracted from the supercritical fluid extraction method. This is deployed in heat sensitive or heat liable essential or the aromatic oils to extract the these type of oils or the concretes or the absolute. Will deploy the supercritical fluid extraction technique. Then here, what are the main solvents we use? Carbon dioxide or liquid nitrogen. they are readily available. These carbon dioxide or the nitrogen is readily available, inexpensive in nature, chemically inert and non-inflammable, means safe to use, and this is non-toxic also and easy to eliminate also. And we can extract a neat extraction without any solvent residue here. This is a supercritical fluid extraction technique. This is also same like as solvent extraction. We will mix up the liquid carbon dioxide or the liquid nitrogen through the flowers. It will extract all the aromatic compounds. This is a sophisticated structure. We will fill for that. Then it will extract the aromatic compounds without the residue of solvent. This is a simple technique, but it contains complex multiple operations. For your exam sake of that, you remember like this. Then this, how this carbon dioxide will extract the chemical components or the aromatic compounds. Here, instead of hexane or the chemical solvents, we will go for the CO2 or nitrogen under the high pressure. High pressure only, the CO2 will convert into liquid. Then only we will call supercritical carbon dioxide. This will be in liquid phase. Then this is the schematic diagram of supercritical fluid. We will load the sample here, like jasmine flower, we will load here. After that, it will come to extraction cell. We'll extract the aromatic compounds. Then we'll go for the preheating. Then the solvent will evaporate. We'll end up with the clear concrete or the absolutes. Then it also contains the cooler, CO2 supply unit and all those things. Then enfluorage. Enfluorage is also one of the technique in order to extract the concrete. Enfluorage or the cold fat extraction technique, maceration, hot fat extraction technique. You remember these two techniques are important. These are all very ancient techniques. These are traditional techniques. Cold fat extraction technique, enfluorage, hot fat extraction technique, maceration. These two are important. Here what will happen, the extraction of essential oils from the petals is done using the pomade. Pomade means it's a saturated fats which contains mostly the pork fat or the cattle fat or the sheep fat. Here the essential oils which are stored in the parenchymal cells such as rose, jasmine, in order to obtain the natural aroma, we use these fats. We'll spread the fat on a fine glass. Then the fat is spread on the above the surface. Then we will place the rose, jasmine or the fine aroma producing crops or the flowers. Then this pomade, you remember, this is the pomade. Pomade means it's a saturated fat mostly from the pork or the fat or the cat, pork fat or the cattle fat or the sheep fat. Here, after extracting the essential oils, we call extrite or the absolute or the pomade, depomade, absolute depomade. You remember, these are the terminologies associated with the enfluorage. Enfluorage, pomade, mostly the fats of pork, cattle, and the extracted compound we call extrite. Okay, this is the equipment used for the enfluoration technique. Then what do you mean by volatile oils or the essential oils? These are the complex liquid mixture of odoriferous principal compounds. What do you mean by odoriferous? Volatile compounds which are easily evaporative in nature. These essential oils mainly used in the therapeutic or flavoring or perfumery industry. Okay, then what are the physical properties of essential oil? mainly it is in liquid in nature, pleasant in smell, and it is extracted through steam distillation unit. These are the some of the physical properties. Listening, right? Srishti, Dev, Ankita, getting the points what I am telling you?
Yes, sir.
These are all very important concepts with respect to your exams. That's why listen carefully. You learn the concepts so that however they ask the questions in the exam, you can easily differentiate the choices and you can choose the best out of right answer. Then how to extract the essential oils? We have different types of distillation, mainly water distillation, water and steam distillation, direct steam distillation. Here hydro distillation means the water is heated to produce the steam which carries the most volatile compounds of the aromatic material within it. The steam is then chilled or condensed to result into essential oil. We'll heat the water, it will carry the all the volatile components, then we'll condense the water, we'll get the essential oil. Simple technique, right? But it contains multiple operations. Here when we come to first method, water distillation, here the plant material is in direct contact with the boiling water. We'll add the rose petal and water, we'll going to boil the water, then we'll extract the essential oil. This is the traditional way of extracting the rose water. You remember this one. Then water and steam distillation. Here the plant material is supported with the perforated screen where the water is contained on the lower part of the still. Still means it's like vessel. Then below that, above that, the material is kept. Assume a liquid, assume a idli patra. Have you heard of idli patra? You know how the idli is prepared in the home? It will contain slime dome shaped vessel. Below that we can add some water like 2 to 3 liters. Above that we will keep a perforated plate. Above that we will keep the rice mixture or the liquid paste of idli. Like that only we'll add the water. Above that we'll keep the perforated plate. Above that we'll keep the plant material. This is the water and steam distillation technique. Then direct steam means here no water is kept in the bottom. The steam is directly introduced through some coil. You assume this idli patra. Here below we'll not keep the water. Instead of we'll keep directly the steam from the pipe, we'll give the steam. So upper part of the plant material will going to extract the volatile compounds. In this picture you can observe this water distillation. Directly the water and the rose petals are mixed here and will give the heat. It will come out, then the volatile compounds are condensed here, will get the essential oil. But in water and steam distillation, in between we'll keep the perforated plate, below that water, and above that plant charge. Plant charge means this is like preparation of planting material in order to extract the essential oil. If they ask plant charge, this terminology belongs to extraction technique of essential oil. Like that you remember. Here in the direct steam distillation, we'll give direct steam. We'll give the direct steam from the perforated tubes. Here the plant materials are kept. Steam distillation unit. Here it is simply shown in this figure. We'll give direct steam. In this picture you can observe separate tank will be there. Here the water is boiled in some other containers. The steam is generated. This steam is directly given for the extracting the essential oil from the another container. It is the big unit compared to other units. This is hydro steam water distillation. This is the plate. This also cleavage operators. for extracting the volatile oils like essential oils. Have you done the practical class on how to extract the jasmine oil from this cleavage apparatus in your lab?
No, sir.
Okay, have you seen these apparatus in your lab?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Here also the same, which we have earlier discussed, the solvent and the plant charge are dissolved here, will heat up from the bottom, the volatile compounds are condensed and will extract the essential oils. Then what are the advantages of cleavage apparatus? They won't ask. These are very compact in nature. We can use in the lab or in any other a home purpose also in order to extract the essential oils. Then influence of distillation and the quality of final product. This distillation, this is the traditional way of extracting the essential oils. Now it is also in Kannauj, majority of Indian essential oils are distilled through hydro distillation technique. Then after extracting the essential oils, they are kept with a anhydrous sodium sulfate, you remember this compound, in order to remove the water or the moisture after extracting the essential oil. You remember this one, anhydrous sodium sulfate, in order to remove the water from the essential oil. How we will go to store the volatile oil? Mainly in the amber glass or the metallic glasses. Have you seen the amber glasses in your laboratory, the brownish glasses? For that, we will going to add the anhydrous sodium sulfate. We will keep in the cool area and tightly closed area at the low temperature. Then have you heard of expression? This is also technique to extract the essential oil, mainly in the citrus rind. Remember this one. Expression is associated with the extraction of essential oil from the citrus rind. Citrus expression. Match the following, this will be definite question. Then we will discuss the major flowers which are all commercially extracted. Mainly these are all the six crops mainly exploited in Indian subcontinent. We will see in detail. In rose, we can see the products like rose oil, rose water, rose attar, rose auto, concrete, absolute. If you need the clear differentiation, if you need the in detail class, this will take up to some 5 to 6 classes. How the rose oil is extracted, rose water, what is the difference, rose attar means what, rose auto means what is the difference between the concrete, absolute. You can differentiate what is the difference between the concrete and absolute. Yes, anyone of you?
Now only concrete is mixed with both, it has some residues also, sir. But
exactly.
Absolute is a pure refined compound, sir.
Yes, exactly.
Contains only that essential oil content or something. Aromatic compound only, sir.
True. The rose concrete is, it contains the aromatic compounds and also the impurities like wax, pigments, other compounds. Absolute means it divides off all the impurities. It contains the fine aromatic compound of rose. That's it. Then these products are used in the perfume industries, powders, creams, soft drinks. What we have a soft drink from rose. What do you call in North India? It is extensively used in the North India. Some soft drink is prepared. In the summertime, you're going to drink that water. What was the soft drink? You heard of Pankuri? Yes, Pankuri. What do you mean by Pankuri?
It's a spelling, sir. Spelling.
You need spelling. Wait, I will show you. Have you heard of rose pankuri? No? These rose petals are mixed with the soft drinks. This is used mainly to in order to scent these in order to flavor the soft drinks. This is extensively used in the North Indian condition or in the subterranean condition, mainly in the summer condition. Okay, this is very important. Pankuri, you remember this one? Then mainly this Bulgarian rose oil is world famous. Bulgaria is the majority a major producer of rose oil. Then you imagine for 5 ml, what is the cost? 800 rupees. This is the demand of natural rose oils or the natural compounds. Then some of we'll see how the rose oil is extracted. Hydro distillation or water distillation technique. Majorly in India we will follow the water distillation or hydro. Hydro nothing but water distillation, don't confuse with that. Then what rose water, how it is followed, how it is extracted? Water distillation only. Then rose attar. Attar means this is also extracted from water distillation, collected over the sandalwood oil. This is the specialty. It is extracted over the sandalwood oil. Then rose otto. This is also repeated water distillation till the water is saturated with the oil, subsequently chilling means condensing to get the essential oil or rose otto. Here citronellol, geraniol, these are all the main components in rose essential oil. Then jasmine. Here essential oil concrete absolutes are prepared out of jasmine. Main producer Egypt. Egypt is the largest producer, followed by Morocco, then India. Then high grade perfumes are charged, or it is highly valuable. For 10 ml it will cost about 3500. You can just imagine what is the demand and what is the craze for the essential oils in world market. Which is the finest oil in the world? Finest jasmine oil in the world. Have you heard of Madurai jasmine oil?
Yes, sir.
This is the finest oil. Then which is the largest producer? Egypt. Then this absolute will be yellowish brown liquid with characteristic natural jasmine smell. Okay, the main chemical constituents are benzoyl acetate, D-linalool. Majorly they will ask the chief constituent of jasmine rose oil, jasmine oil. You should go for the choice like jasmine acetate, because about 65% of the oil consists of jasmine acetate. There are n number of compounds, more than 1000 compounds will be present in the jasmine oil. In spite of that, this is the chief constraint which cause for the natural jasmine smell. Then for the tuberose, extraction techniques for solvent extraction and flourage are followed. Here we will not follow the hydro distillation technique. They will definitely going to ask this type of questions in the exam. In the tuberose, which among the following technique is not followed? They will give solvent extraction, enflurage, or maceration, or supercritical fluid extraction technique. Then they will give hydro distillation or water distillation technique. Then you have to choose the water distillation technique. Then the majority compound will be concrete, tuberose concrete. You see, in concrete, what will have? Waxy mosses. Then esters of aromatic compounds. In the absolute, what will have? Thick brownish liquid. Devoid of all the impurities. Then what is the main composition or the chief component? Benzyl benzoate, benzyl alcohol. Then kevda, kevda or pandanus. Have you heard of basmati leaf used for the biryani making or palav making?
Yes.
This is what kevda, kevda oil. This is the main compound in. What are the main products? The main product from the Kemeda water is distilled from the male flowers. You remember the male flowers will going to extract the Kevda oil. Hydro distillation technique we follow. Here also for 10 ml, 2500 will be the cost. They won't ask the cost in your exam, but for your sake, I am telling you all these things. India is the largest producer of Kevda oil in the world market. Mainly used in the perfumes, flavoring the food, then desserts. Then the main chemical components here is 2-phenylethylmethylether is the main component. Then have you heard of GCMS? What do you mean by GCMS? Gas chromatography, mass spectroscopy. These are the techniques followed in order to analyze the essential oils or the absolutes or the aromatic compounds. Here we can know which is the compounds which are all there in the essential oils. We said these are the components in the Kevda oil. How you came to know? We have analyzed through GCMS. We have n number of techniques for the analysis: liquid gas chromatography, gas chromatography, mass spectroscopy. These are the important techniques to analyze the essential oils. This is also one of the very vast subject in order to evaluate the chemicals present in the essential oils. For your sake, you need to remember these are the techniques used for the analysis of essential oil quality to determine the quantity compounds in the essential oil. Here we'll have mainly two phase. One is solid phase or liquid phase. One is movable and one is constant phase. In the movable and the constant, only we'll have liquid type, solid liquid type and gas type. I think it is very hard to digest this topic for you guys. I will just simply brief you out how the compounds are identified. First we will fill the compound essential oil for the gas chromatography. It's a sophisticated instrument. It will go into evaporate this in that chamber only. It will have some heaters. It will going to evaporate. Then for the evaporated essential oils will reaches some peaks. Then another instrument detector will detect which are the compounds present in the peaks. These are all the peaks observed in the gas chromatography. This is called, what do you call for this? Chromatography. For this chart, we will call chromatography. Chromatography is associated with respect to gas chromatography or mass spectroscopy. From this peak only, we will identify this is linalool, this is geraniol, this is methyl acetate, like that. The primitive copper stills used in the Kannur district in order to extract the rose water. Nowadays we will go for the steam distillation technique. These are the instruments, sophisticated instruments in order to extract the rose solvent extraction. The solvent is mixed in the rose petals. I have said na, liquid liquid extraction techniques, solid liquid extraction techniques. We have n number of techniques, but these are all very hard to digest to you. But these are all also not they won't ask this much in-depth questions for you. Have you heard of fractional distillation unit? Fractional distillation is unit is mainly used in order to separate the different compounds present in the essential oil or the any compound or any mixture of compound. You remember, fractional distillation unit is mainly used in order to separate the compounds. Supercritical fluid extraction technique. Extraction chamber, then the fractionation separating chamber, then condensation chamber, and the CO2 storage or the nitrogen storage will be there. This is the simple apparatus followed in your laboratory. We'll heat this, it will condense. The hot water will be rotated here and the cold water is circulated. So this is condenser. Then we will get the mixture of essential oil here. Then this is the cold fired extraction. The pomade is used here. On that we are going to place the flowers. These are the rose oil storage containers. Rose candles also prepared. After extracting the absolute, the left out wax material, pigment material, will that impurities is used for the preparing candles. These candles also having some fragrance. I think this is enough for the today class. Board of.
Yes.
You are bored of this class?
No, sir.
Okay. I hope you understood a little bit on the full concepts. But these are all very important with respect to your competitive exams like JRF, NEET, SRF. You will definitely expect some 4 to 5 questions on this concept. Which are the techniques used? What do you mean by absolute or concrete? Which is the chief component present in this club, this cover, this crop, like that they will going to ask. Then any other doubts or queries, let me know.
No, sir.
The recording has stopped.
No queries.